Russia's main rival, the U.S., has a true blue water navy. A blue water navy is a maritime force that's capable of operating globally in deep waters of open oceans and is not restricted to only operation near the nation's homeland or in shallow waters. The U.S. operates more than 10 nuclear-powered supercarriers that enables it to project power far away from its mainland. American Carrier Strike Group can be used to enforce naval blockade, which makes them a strategic tool. Russia doesn't have a budget to have such a massive navy, especially it can't field and operate so many highly expensive supercarriers like America. Taking this into consideration, Russia has taken up a different approach to counter the U.S. Navy. One of the main components of this strategy is the deployment of anti-ship missiles along the Russian coastline. This consists of two tier concept, the Bal-E and Bastion mobile coastal defense missile systems. The Bal-E maintains tactical defense of the coast, while the Bastion engages targets at longer ranges. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how powerful is the Russian Bal-E and Bastion coastal anti-ship missile system. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank or aircraft and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. The Bal-E is the successor to Soviet-era Redu. It's meant to provide cover to territorial waters, naval bases, other coastal infrastructure. It's designated as SSC-6 Cenite by NATO. These systems' development was led by SCRPC, Konstruktorskoye Byuro Mashinostroy Enia, and included more than 10 corporations. Bal-E is capable of performing its duties in daytime and at night, even in adverse weather conditions. It includes up to 2 mobile command control centers, up to 4 self-propelled launching vehicles, and up to 4 transport and refueling vehicles. The system uses KH-35E missile. The KH-35E missile is a subsonic weapon capable of reaching speeds of Mach 0.8 to Mach 0.95. The missile is designed for sea-skimming flight and is capable of hitting targets located up to 75 miles or 120 kilometers away. It uses a turbofan engine for propulsion and is guided by an active radar seeker. It has a low radar return because of its small size and stealthy characteristics. A Bal-E system can launch a total of 32 KH-35E missiles with a maximum interval of up to 3 seconds. It can be made combat ready in less than 10 minutes. The Bastion Coastal Defense System is designed to engage surface fighting ships and auxiliaries vessels that are operating standalone or part of a task force. The system is in development since the late 1970s, but after major delays, it entered the service in 2010. When the first 3 systems were delivered to the Russia's Black Sea Fleet. It's manufactured by the NPO Mashinostroyenia Rocket Design Bureau. A typical Bastion battery is composed of 1 or 2 command and control vehicles based on the Kamaz 43-101 6x6 truck, 1 support vehicle, 4 launcher vehicles based on the MZKT 7930 8x8 chassis, each having 2 missiles and 4 loader vehicles. Because of the mobility of the system, it can be hard to neutralize with a preemptive strike. Bastion is a distributed system, and the launcher vehicles can be located up to 16 miles or 25 kilometers away from the command and control vehicles. After the launchers take up a particular position, they can be readied for firing within 5 minutes. The system uses the Yakont anti-ship cruise missile. The missile has a range of 75 miles or 120 kilometers when using low altitude sea skimming flight path, and around 180 miles or 300 kilometers when using a high to low altitude flight path, in which the missile flies at high altitude and changes to sea skimming trajectory in the terminal phase of the flight. The missile is fired vertically from the launchers. It uses a solid fuel rocket booster for initial acceleration, and then employs a liquid fuel ramjet engine, which enables it to achieve a sustained speed of Mach 2.5. Because of the supersonic speed, it's very hard to defend against. It has a 250 kilogram semi-armor piercing high explosive warhead. Yakut uses GLONASS for navigation during the initial flight stage and switches to active radar guidance for terminal phase guidance. Russian plan of deploying sophisticated anti-ship coastal defenses is a classic asymmetrical warfare strategy. An attempted strike from sea against Russia will be countered through a barrage of anti-ship missiles. These could extract huge amount of toll on the rival Navy. Even for the U.S. Navy, a confrontation like this will be hard to manage, since the cost of an anti-ship missile is minuscule when compared to U.S. Navy warships like Arleigh Burke-class destroyer or Nimitz or Ford supercarrier. Russia will be able to launch a volley of these missiles from different directions and having different trajectory, making it very difficult to intercept all of them. A saturation strike like this will most likely see some of these missiles penetrating the elaborate defenses of the American carrier strike group. It's highly likely that even a single shot from these missiles could disable or even sink a warship. This is an effective defensive posturing that makes the Russian homeland seem like a fortress.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.